Rwanda may be a small country in the African continent, but it holds many wonders that would make tourists list Rwanda on their bucket lists of countries they have to see. So, buckle up as we share with you 10 of the most interesting facts about this tiny but incredibly amazing country, Rwanda. Number 10. Rwanda is known as the Land of a Thousand Hills. Rwanda has gotten this nickname for the literal reasons of having many hills in its border. This has to be because of the fact that Rwanda is a landlocked nation. It is a country that is completely surrounded by land, with no access to the sea. Rwanda is true to its nickname, as it is mainly characterized by its hills and mountainous terrains that are seen in almost all towns and cities around the country, that are located at substantial elevations. On average, the country is 1,000 meters above sea level and usually never goes down at sea level. Rwanda is indeed filled with thousand hills. Number 9. Rwanda is a major coffee and tea producer. One of the things tourists must have when they visit Rwanda is their coffee. Rwanda has its high elevations and soil quality to thank for the delicious treat that is their coffee. As coffee became one of their specialties, they have decided to make use of them for their economic boost. Over the past decade, the country's coffee industry has been a great factor in their impressive economic force. Rwanda is the world's 9th largest producer of Arabica coffee, and it is the country's 4th largest export item. Rwanda exports more than 80% of its coffee to the world, so it is very possible that you might taste Rwandan Arabica coffee beans once in your life. If you love and drink coffee, of course. Please make sure to hit the like button before we continue the video. And for more potential updates, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Number 8. It shelters the endangered mountain gorillas. Mountain gorillas are gorgeous animals, and it is an exquisite experience to see them enjoy their life in their natural habitat. However, due to poaching and loss of habitat, it has been identified as endangered. However, Rwanda is home to almost 60% of its global population, specifically in the Virunga Massif. Diane Fossey made them famous with the help of his studies about the gorillas that are residing in the country. Rwanda is a very disciplined and strict country when it comes to the conservation of wildlife and rules in general, which is why they only allow less than 100 tourists to take part in their gorilla tracking program that is very costly, which can come up to more than $1,000. This might seem very expensive, but this is the government's effort to preserve the natural habitats of the gorillas as well as improve the conservation efforts. Just recently, the Ellen DeGeneres Wildlife Fund was established to aid the highly salient effort of Diane Fossey to conserve the gorillas. Number 7. Honey is a must for Rwanda visitors. Aside from the fantastic coffee of the country, Rwanda also boasts its sweet honey. The surrounding area of the Akagera National Park is the country's main source of honey, and with the government's initiatives, a buffer zone was created around the national park to demoralize poachers. To replace the income of the poachers, bees and honey farms were created. These farms are also a bright idea to encourage conservation and preservation of not just bees, but also other wildlife present in the national park. These farms and cafes are also a way for the neighboring communities to have a sustainable livelihood for them to get by. Surely, the implementation of these farms and cafes is hitting two birds with one stone. Number 6. You will not see any plastic bags in this country. What most people do not know about Rwanda is that it is among the cleanest countries in the world. You will almost never see any trash around the country, and it is always remarkably clean. The cleanliness of the whole country is partly due to the nationwide plastic ban in the country since 2008. The country takes the ban seriously. Even before entering the country, tourists will be up for inspections and their luggage will be checked to see if they have any plastic bags and will be confiscated upon arrival. The cleanliness of the country should not just be credited to the government, but as well as responsible citizens. Number 5. 60% of its parliament members are female. Another thing that the world may not know about Rwanda is that 60% of its parliament members are female. Ever since 2003, Rwanda has had consistently high proportional female parliamentary representation in the world. Another thing is that out of the 7 Supreme Court justices of the country, 4 are women. Talk about female domination. Number 4. Rwanda is Africa's most gender-equal country. In addition to the female domination of the country's parliament, Rwanda is Africa's most gender-equal country, and the world's 9th. This ranking is according to the 2020 Gender Gap Index, which measures gender equality by the relative gaps between men and women in different aspects, such as education, politics, economy, and health. Number 3. There is a car-free day each month. Another way for the government to promote sustainability and good health, Rwanda has implemented a car-free day each month that allows the streets of Rwanda to take a breath from the vehicle traffic, and its people get to walk around and take in the beauty of the country in various recreational activities, such as biking, roller skating, and other outdoor sports. Number 2. There is a day every month that is dedicated to community service. Rwanda has taken progressiveness to another whole level with their implementation, of which the whole country gets to dedicate half a day every last Saturday of the month to community service. This is also an effort of the government to help unite the people after the gruesome 1994 Rwandan genocide. Number 1. This country has inspired some of the greatest dramas of all time. Although this fact might be known to some, it is still worth sharing. Rwanda has been showcased in not just one, but two of the greatest dramas of all time. Hotel Rwanda was inspired by the story of Paul Rusesabagina, the manager of the Hotel des Mille Collines, who were able to help hundreds of Rwandan citizens from the 1994 genocide. Another drama based on the 1998 movie Gorillas in the Mist shares a story about a naturalist who studied the mountain gorillas of the country. Until now, the locations of the movies are famous tourist spots in the country. Phew! What a progressive country indeed! We hope you enjoyed this one, and see you next time!